Justice
Morris, I've got a form here for a 10-mile police charity run in aid of the Children's Society. Can I put you down as a runner?
Are you serious?
Of course, I'm serious. The police department does the charity run every year. This year, we've decided to run in aid of the Children's Society. Morris, I take that as a no.
Boy number 9.
Boy number 9. What delight do you have to show over me today?
The tailor and the butcher had plenty of money laying around, just waiting for me to grab.
Good.
$1,900 is in all.
Any problems?
No. Just some undercover cop that tried to chase me down, but he was too slow. I left him panting.
Good. I hope he didn't hide anything from me.
No. You know I can't do such a thing to you, Naworo.
Good. $1,900 is would definitely make our day. Who is it?
You're meeting your new partner this afternoon, Morris. Looking for what to eat?
You haven't given me a choice in the matter.
Choice is for people with too much time on their hands. You're too busy fighting crime to worry about choice. So I make the choices for you.
So on this occasion, you think me having a partner is the right choice?
I wouldn't have made it otherwise.
This detective Law's got a bit of reputation. What's he done to deserve this?
She is Delia Law, the child of Marshal Modou Law, the first police officer in this country to serve in the forces for
over 40 years. I know who Marshal Law is. But what I don't understand is why the hell his daughter wants to work in law enforcement in the Gambia of all places.
Ask her that yourself. Oh, and Morris.
Yeah?
I have put your name down as a definite for next week's charity run.
Thanks.
Don't mention it.
I don't understand you.
How do I look?
Baby, you look great. I don't understand. We haven't seen each other since Dad was killed.
8 years ago.
8 years ago? And you just turned up from Sweden yesterday, from out of the blues, telling me you want to join the Banjul Cops as a detective?
That's right.
Delia, what is wrong with you? Are you crazy?
Do I look crazy to you?
No.
Do I sound crazy to you?
No.
But then what's the problem?
Listen to me, Delia. I love you. You are my younger sister. The police force is dangerous. It's no place for girls like you, especially in Africa.
Listen to me, Fatu. If the force was good enough for our father to spend his whole adult life devoted to it, it's definitely good enough for me.
So, you're not going to change your mind, are you?
Why would I change my mind?
Because people change. And when people change, minds change too.
When or if I change my mind, you'll be the first to know.
I just hope so.
Is it painful?
I feel nothing other than that which should be there but is not. Does that sound strange, Doctor?
Not at all. I understand you fully. You see, when a limb is amputated, it's often the case that the patient may feel a ghost limb for many months and in some cases for years. But what strikes me is you have no memory of this organ being removed at all.
No, Doctor. All I remember is trying to go to the toilet. That's when I realized it was gone.
It's okay. It's all right. Extraordinary, wouldn't you say?
I certainly would. So what are you saying? All those are pictures of
men's private parts.
But they don't have any parts.
We are seeing at least one case like this every week. We have about a dozen cases on my ward.
Fascinating. So how can I help, Omar? This is only some form of severe medical condition.
Brought on by what though, Maurice?
You're supposed to be the doctor here.
Brought on by no force of nature. I can tell you that for nothing.
I don't understand.
If you look closely, Maurice, you will see here and here that there are no removal marks, no stitches, no sign of disease, nothing.
Go on.
And all of these men had fully operational organs in this region only 24 hours prior to them being removed. Don't you see, Maurice? It's the organ snatcher. He's back.
Excuse me. I've been waiting here very patiently for nearly 3 hours.
That's good. You've got a lot of patience.
I was told if I come today, I'll be able to talk to Miss Law about her new role in the police force.
Who told you that?
Chief Joe.
Yes. You definitely need all that patience.
I'm running out.
Why not go home and come back in the morning? You should have topped upon your supply of patience by then. Okay, hold on. I'll see what I can do.
These guys have no recollection of their genitalia being removed whatsoever.
None. But the doctor did say that prior to their organs going missing, all of the men have recently spent time in or around Bakau Market.
Chief Joe, the man from the Daily Echo wants to know when he can interview the new detective.
Tell him she's not ready.
Yes, sir.
You've got press interview lined up already?
We live in a media age, Maurice. We've got to maintain a good relationship with the press.
I don't want to visit your mother this weekend.
You will do exactly as I tell you. But nothing. I have worn the trousers in this house for over 10 years since we got married. And that is not going to change overnight.
But
you will visit my mother whether you like it or not.
This is the reception, obviously.
Detective Law?
Yes?
I'm George Drummond from the Daily Echo.
Sorry, George. You'll have to wait until Delia has finished her induction. This is the serious crime unit. You'll be based in here
but you probably get to do a lot of work with these guys. Serious fraud office, drug squad, scientific support unit. Oh, that's your trap. Come, I'll show you where we keep the suspects.
Maurice?
Yeah, it's me, Omar.
I was going to suggest you take a ride over the Bakal market.
It's funny you still mention that.
Yeah, I thought it was a good idea.
Stop, stop, thief, thief!
It's a real pleasure having you on the force, Delia.
I feel honored.
Believe me, the honor is all ours. If someone had told me that I would one day be working with the great Marshal Law's daughter, I would have said that could not be.
Really, Chief?
Call me Albert, for today at least.
Albert, when I was growing up, my father always, although I didn't see him much, he always instilled in me a simple sense of what's right and what's wrong.
Of course.
When he died 8 years ago, I just knew I had to come back and make a stand in his name.
And catch his killers?
Definitely catch his killers.
We never closed your father's case. It's too soon, Delia. You need to settle in first before I assign your father's case to you. I'm not even sure if there's a good idea for you. There are a lot of emotions involved.
Okay. No, you have no right to deny me this.
You're right. I can't deny you this. But I have the authority. Delia, let's get you settled in first. I would like to introduce you to your partner, Maurice Justice.
Justice?
That's right. Law and justice. It's got a great ring to it, don't you think?
I would rather you didn't mention this to anyone. The fact that a medical doctor is recommending that I see a weak doctor only because medical science does not have the answer to my patient's ailment. Come tell me, have the answer.
Oh.
Detective Delia Law, I would like you to meet Detective Maurice Justice. Maurice, you make sure Delia feels welcome.
Sure.
You probably got a lot of things to talk about, so I'll let you get on with it.
So, Detective Delia Law.
That's me.
I've heard a lot about you.
All good, I'm sure.
All good. That's your desk.
So, do you enjoy working here?
That depends on what day it is. If I put a hardened criminal behind bars, then it's a great day. If I don't, then things could go either way.
That's an interesting way of looking at things.
Trust me, in this job, it's the only way to look at things.
What are you working on at the moment?
I've got a cabinet full of things to work on, but I've got two cases on the boil right now. One is a child criminal racket, and the other...
The other?
Do what I will explain on the way.
I have it all.
Wait, wait! I can't accept money until the ceremony is over. Put your money away.
I want that one.
Which one? Can't you see this one is bigger than this one? Then you have to pay much more for it.
I have the money.
You have the money?
Yes, I have the money.
Then so it shall be.
I'm sorry. I just can't believe there's a guy going around removing males' genitalia without the victim's knowledge.
You want proof? I can take you straight onto a ward run by Dr. Omar at the Central Hospital. I can give you 12 living, breathing bits of proof if you wish.
I can't believe my first case is to find some crackpot removing men's genitalia.
Well, one thing's for certain. You've got great timing.
I just can't believe it. What? What?
You better take "I can't believe" out of your vocabulary. This is Africa. And one thing you can't afford to do in Africa is stop believing. You think your father stopped believing, huh? You think your father stopped believing something fantastical as life after death? Have you stopped believing in life after death? No, I didn't think so. So you can so still believe that there are forces out there capable of taking your genitalia without you even knowing it. So if you stop believing in Africa, you may as well stop breathing in Africa. Remember that, okay?
Okay. Okay.
You Europeans are so flat-minded. This is where it's supposed to take place. Hello? What's wrong with him?
What's wrong?
It's Joseph. He's been taken ill.
Who's Joseph?
My son. He's burning up!
Are you gonna be okay?
Yeah. I hope you will feel better soon, Joseph.
Oh, he'll be fine.
I will be in touch this evening to see how he's getting on.
Yeah, I'll take him straight home. Thanks.
Okay, Joseph.
I'll take him straight home. The doctor is there waiting.
All right, I'll go with you.
Help me.
The injection will take effect straight away. The antibiotics will hold over a longer period. I've also given him a painkiller, so he should be able to sleep now.
Oh, thanks, Omar. He was literally boiling up.
Once in the system, these kinds of bugs can quadruple the temperature in minutes.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's going to be fine.
Thank God.
Check in on him at least once an hour and follow the prescriptions I've given you. Give him lots of liquid that will help cleanse the system. Other than that, you should see a major improvement by morning.
Oh, thanks, Omar.
If you have any suspicions or doubts, don't hesitate to call.
Thank you so much, Doctor.
Don't mention it.
I'll go and check up on Joseph.
Oh. I had no idea you had a son.
Joseph is a handful at best of times, but I love him.
Of course. And Ma Zainab?
My mother.
You still live with your mom?
I can explain.
No. That's kind of sweet, I think.
What about you? You must have some family in the Gambia.
Yeah, of course. Aunts, cousins, uncles.
Brothers or sisters?
Just an older sister.
Look, I'm sorry I screamed at you earlier.
That's okay. I probably deserve that.
I don't have the right. It's your first day. I'm supposed to make you feel welcome.
Don't worry. You'll make it up to me sometime.
He's fast asleep already.
Look, Ma, do you mind looking after Joseph? We got to get back.
Since when did you need to ask me to look after my grandson? Hey! I've just finished making some fresh benachim. Sit yourself down and put some food in you before you leave this house.
We got to get on.
Well, benachim, that sounds great. I'm starving.
Me too.
Anyway, that was when I met Maurice's father. In 1962, that was a wonderful summer.
Gambia must have changed a lot since then.
Oh yes. Back then, tarmac roads were unheard of, and the only people who had constant electricity were the British.
So how do you feel?
I feel I could rip up someone's head without thinking about it.
so you feel emasculated.
I feel liberated.
I am Judith Figo. I have the whole world in my hand. It's $25,000 is.
You said 20?
But he took the biggest in the box.
Come on, come on. Please, come on.
Look, look. I'm giving you courage to challenge me. But I can still take it back if I want to.
No, 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 please. No, no. 25 it is? No, no.
Where the hell have you been all day? Have you forgotten that I wear the trousers in this house? Have you forgotten that I tell you what to do and when?
Yes, I have forgotten all of that. I am now in charge. Give me those. You will never wear trousers in this house again.
Thank you for such a lovely meal.
Don't mention it. I'm just happy that Maurice has got a lovely partner looking after him on the job.
Okay, bye, Mom. We'll see you.
Bye.
Good night.
Night night.
That was embarrassing.
Your mother's sweet.
She's a kind lady. What about your mother? Is she based in Sweden?
Right now, I'm guessing she's based in heaven.
Heaven?
I have a stepmom here in the Gambia, but my real mom died a long time ago.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. I have really good memories of her. I keep them with me all the time. This was a great day, and that was a great welcome.
Really?
I did say you'd make it up to me.
Yeah, right. I'll pick you up in the morning. Good night.
Well, well, well. When are you going back to Sweden?
I'm not going back.
Wait a minute. You mean you're going back to work tomorrow?
When are you gonna get this into your head? I'm here to stay.
Suit yourself.
I know Delia is an attractive lady, but I didn't expect you to take her to meet parents on the first day.
It wasn't like that.
Whatever. How's the kid?
Joseph is a lot better now.
Good. What about progress on the organ snatcher?
Nothing to mention. I'll pick it up in the morning.
This may seem pretty obvious, Maurice, but keep your home and private life separate from now on.
I understand. Get over here. Is that what you call food? I want chicken. Good Lord. Do I have the fax instructions to you?
Before Joseph got ill yesterday, Dr. Omar insisted we see a guy called Contella.
Dr. Omar? He's the doctor that's been looking after the genitally challenged patients?
Yeah, he's a busy man.
So who is this Contella guy?
He's another doctor.
Okay.
Well, Contella is not a medical doctor. He's a witch doctor.
Okay.
Omar thinks he can help with the investigation.
I admire men like you.
Why?
Well, you wait minute after minute, hour after hour, day after day, all day round. And even if you don't get what you want, you are prepared to come back the next day and do the whole thing again.
It's my job.
It all makes sense now.
What do you mean?
Now I understand why I didn't pay a journalist well.
Contella, we want to thank you for seeing us at such short notice.
You should thank Dr. Omar for that. He's a very good doctor, you know.
So, what can you tell us about the organ snatcher, Contella?
The organ snatcher is a very simple being. In that, he only ever snatches organs that have meaning beyond their function.
Beyond functions?
I get it. The penis functions as a waste disposal and reproductive organ, but represents and symbolizes power, strength, and virility.
Precisely.
And what of the heart that often has the meaning of love and compassion?
We live in a cruel world, detective. Think about it. Given a chance, most people would much rather have more power and strength than love and compassion.
Hence, more penises have been snatched than hearts.
Besides, men can survive without penis, but not without a heart.
Of course.
The organ snatchers are not murderers, detective, but a conjurer and a transfer of vital energies from one being to another.
So what's he doing with the victim's genitals?
We live in a market economy, detective.
He sells them?
To the highest bidder, not the genital itself, you understand, that remains with him, but certainly its vital energy is available in a retail kind of way.
Like a sort of a form of ancient Viagra?
Yes, but 1,000 times more potent.
1,000 times more potent?
Wow!
Of course! Back in time, only the king had access to such wizardry. How do you think they kept legions of wives satisfied? They were not kings for nothing.
And what of the men that lost their manhood?
They had a guaranteed career in the king's harem as eunuch. And there were many stories of men happily offering to sacrifice their manhood for the king. In many parts, it was seen as an honor.
Some honor?
And that's it?
No, not quite. The process is reversible. It is possible for the organ to return to its originator.
Reattach?
Yeah.
Without any adverse effects?
Not quite.
I know it.
You see, while the organ is not used physically, its vital energy is. Masses of energy is used up very quickly. As with any energy source, the more it is used, the quicker it runs out until it's empty.
And then?
Well, let's just say many eunuchs get their organs back, but they remain eunuchs.
Spent?
Completely.
So where do we find the organ snatcher?
He has a tendency to find you, detective. Now, if you will excuse me.
Hey, before you leave. Tell me, how does the organ snatcher choose his victims?
Simple. It's like a strong, powerful, commanding man like you.
I used to hate history at school, but if Contella were my history teacher, I swear I would have majored in history. What are you thinking?
Oh, Contella gave us some useful information.
But nothing that leads us to the organ snatcher.
Nothing obvious anyway.
I've read about people like Contella. The clues to the problems are always hidden.
George from the Daily Echo.
You were here yesterday.
That's right. I wanted to arrange a time to interview you.
Why?
I think the Gambia people will be very interested to hear what the daughter of the late great martial law has to say about you choosing a career in law enforcement in the Gambia.
They'll have to remain interested.
I'm sorry.
I don't do interviews.
I've been waiting patiently.
Did you hear what the lady said, George? No interviews.
Law and justice. What more could the police force want?
Extended holiday, fully funded retirement at 40.
I hope Maurice is setting a good example to you, Delia.
Really good.
You were out visiting this Kinshasa guy.
Contella, his name.
I don't care what he is called. Did you have any useful leads?
Well,
no leads, but some useful information.
We know, for instance, this snatcher goes for strong, powerful men.
What motivates this guy?
Well, what motivates half the world's population?
I know that rhino horn, shark teeth, elephant tusk are highly sought after the world over. But I had no idea that men savored manhood were demand.
Well, according to Constella, they're in great demand.
We're going to head back down to Bakau Market, ask around, see what we can pick up. Chief, there's a guy downstairs.
Craggy looking guy with glasses?
George.
From the Daily Echo?
That's right.
He's my nephew.
I told you, I didn't want any press when I joined.
He's my nephew. I always feed him exclusives when I get them. I promised him one with you when I knew you were coming.
No press means no press.
Okay, no press. But just remember that you might need them one day.
Don't say it. These journalists.
Just do the interview, Delia. It's not going to hurt anyone.
I'm a detective, Morris. I don't do interviews.
Well, it's your call.
He's much better. He's even talking about going back to school tomorrow.
We'll have to give it a couple of days before you send him back to school, okay? I'll see you later.
He's well?
Ah, he's a strong kid.
I was thinking about the snatcher.
Go on.
Well, Cantella said that the snatcher looks for the strong, virile type of male.
I'm listening.
And where do most strong, sporty type males hang out when they want to display themselves?
Justice,
I've just had the commission on the phone. The snatcher has taken from the defense minister.
What?
Our man has money to snatch himself some ministerial meat. The commission is going crazy. They want this snatcher guy caught. And fast.
Ah.
Now what?
Out! He's stolen my purse!
Stop, police!